at the very beginning, I call Mr. C. Gunawardena, who is a lecturer in the University of Kelaniya. He's engaged in teaching and facilitating students in learning French. Now he's going to present his paper, An Analysis of Pronunciation of Error Committed by Sinhala Speaking Learners When They Speak, When They Study French. I invite Mr. Gunawardena to present his paper. Anyway, you get only 12 minutes to present your thing.
Dear Chair Professor, lecturers, senior lecturers, lecturers, students, very good afternoon to you. So I'm going to present my paper, An Analysis of Pronunciation Committed by Sinhala Speaking Learners of French. The paper presents an analysis of errors related to pronunciation. The corpus was collected at the University of Kelaniya in 2012. And the presented errors gives a general explanation of the difficulties faced by French interlanguage. So I'll start with an introduction. So it's a general observation made by teachers and students is that learners of French as a foreign language in Sri Lanka have major difficulties with French pronunciation, even after years of learning and practice. This is actually because the lack of attention given paid to pronunciation in the classroom, both by teachers and students. So why pronunciation is difficult for learners? I believe there are two perceptions for this question. This is in general terms, in any given language. So one is psychological, which is psychologists believe that it's something to do with the cognitive ability. And the other one is phonological or linguistics. So my research is based on the linguistic or the phonological perception. The objective of the study to present a contrastive analysis of the both system, phonological system, to identify errors related to a pronunciation made by Sri Lankan interlanguage, to analyze and classify errors, to suggest some pedagogical implication, which would be eventually helpful for Sri Lanka and other fellow scholars. The why this study is important. So this question has not been studied before in Sri Lanka. The pronunciation errors made by Sri Lankan, French Sri Lankan interlanguage. So I believe that the study will give a very good picture of the degree of difficulties faced by students. And eventually, we could find remedial measures which could be applied in the classroom. The literature review, so the study is basically based on error analysis theory, which gives the theoretical background for this study. I just rushed through this because of the limited time. So Pete Corder developed the error analysis as an alternative to contrastive analysis. He said the contrastive analysis gives hypothetical data, whereas beg your pardon, contrastive analysis give hypothetical data, whereas error analysis gives a clear picture of how the learner learns the language and what difficulties he or she faces during the foreign language acquisition. Richards was the first one to present a very good study. So as you can see, I just rushed through this. Now for English learners learning French, French center and front vowels used round lips in English, and they are made with neutral lips in English, so they find difficulties. Dental fricatives, the French, the French learners replace or substitute them with z and s, so which leads to mispronunciation. So with recent studies, Diwali 2002, professor at University of Berwick explained the interference of English in the French interlanguage in India. So I just rush through this. The scope of the study. So I only focus on the word phonology. So I would not examine the suprasegmental features. So I would just need to narrow down the studies to give a better picture of the errors. So hypothesis: Sinhala speaking learners learning French as a foreign language will encounter difficulties related to pronunciation due to interference of Sinhala. So proficiency of the learners, despite the proficiency of the learner, interlanguage of first language will not disappear in the learner's interlanguage, which means that the learners, errors will appear as fossilized errors. Similarities between French and Sinhala will facilitate the learning acquisition, whereas difference between the two languages will make the learning challenging. Intralingual interference is more evident among proficiency learners. Methodology analysis produce the theoretical background for the study. Participants, 30 undergraduates were selected for the study. The corpus or the sample, represented one male and 29 females. They belong to three language proficiency levels. Each proficiency level represented 10 learners. So the corpus was recorded using a battery operated audio tape recorder. Each recording at approximately took 15 minutes, and the corpus was transcribed using an international phonetic alphabet. Findings: these are the vowels in French. So I'll rush through this. These vowels exist only in French. There are five shared vowels. So nasal vowels, both languages share four nasal vowels. Consonants, I just rushed through this to save some time. So the shared vowels are given in green, just to give an. So I came to the findings. So now the vowels are given and the graphemes are given. So the most problematic graphemes are given. For example, when the vowel E is represented by double E, so the basic learners made 90% of the basic learners found it difficult to pronounce, whereas 30% independent learners and 10% advanced learners. So this is a statistical analysis. So most of the time E was replaced by its longer counterpart, which is instead of saying E, they would say E. When it's represented by HA, the grapheme, 90%, 95% basic learners, 95% independent learners, and 70% advanced learners found it difficult to pronounce. So which means that they are carrying the, you know, despite of the proficiency level, you know, they are carrying the their mistakes. Not, it doesn't, I mean, the errors is could be classified as fossilized. So other important vowel would be U, and when it is represented by U, 95% of basic learners found it difficult to pronounce. Most of the time it they replace with U in Sinhala. 70% of independent learners, 40% of advanced learners. So other, all the vowels are given here, so just we'll move on. Now, replace the place of articulation of French vowels and Sinhala vowels, these are shared vowels. As you can see now, the French vowels and Sinhala vowels, the place of articulation is different. The in Sinhala it is much more open, E is much more open. And O is in Sinhala, it's much more open. Just I'll rush through this. So we it was shown that since the place of articulation is different, a native-like pronunciation is very difficult to acquire. And so the teacher should treat this as variations rather than mistakes. These are diphthongs, and the mistakes made by, there are 10 diphthongs in French. So the mistakes are given here. So we'll move on to nasal vowels. For example, when it's represented, these are the most problematic graphemes. 90% of the basic learners found it difficult. So as you can see, still, even among advanced learners, we have, they found it difficult to pronounce. So these are nasal vowels, four nasal vowels and mistakes, representing the four proficiency levels. And the consonants here, I have given the most important graphemes. So for example, P, when it's represented by graphemes BT, the 15% of basic learners, 5%, and for example, no advanced learners made mistakes related to P. So as discussion, interlanguage, interlingual errors were the most prominent errors. For example, du is some in French, so they would pronounce as du. And this changes completely the meaning of the word. Du is some. And do is soft in French. So likewise, I'll just, second language interference also prominent. And intralingual errors were the errors within the language, and shared vowels, E, short E, when these are vowels shared by two languages, but still they found it difficult to pronounce. The conclusion, the study reveals the most of the errors were occurred due to first language interference. Similarities between the two languages do not always facilitate pronunciation acquisition. Interlingual errors occur especially among independent learners. Interlingual errors do not completely disappear, and they appear as fossilized. So the implication, the findings will help to understand the degree of difficulty faced by Sri Lankan interlanguage. This to have this will help to identify the common errors related to pronunciation belong to three proficiency level. The place of articulation is important to understand. So it also represents gives the remedial measures for fossilized errors. And for future research, I think we have to do a longitude study to understand how the implication should be applied in the classroom. Okay. Thank you very much.